Hey, what's going on, people? So in this video we're gonna be exploring the sequencing features of the Maschine MK3 and specifically the quantize and swing settings. I'll also be showing you how to step sequence your drums, and we're gonna be exploring the grid settings, which are really crucial. So yeah, welcome to the channel, guys. I'm Low Heat, and I do tutorials about Ableton Live, Ableton Push 2, the Maschine MK3. I also do Ableton Live packs, so subscribe to the channel. Without further ado, let's get into the tutorial. Okay, so first of all, let's have a look at the grid settings. So we press Shift plus the follow button. So yeah, the first type of grid that we can set is the perform grid. So this basically determines how the transitions between different scenes is done. So if it's set to 1/16th, the transition occurs at the next 16th note as you trigger the next scene. If you preset it to 1 bar, it waits for the next bar. This is the arrange grid, which basically determines the pattern length and the section length that you can set in the arrange page. So these basically are the increments at which patterns and section lengths are set. But for this tutorial, we're gonna pay most attention to the step grid, as this is the one that actually determines what happens when you sequence your notes, when you quantize them. So the default value is 1/16th. So this means that as I record my notes and I press the quantize button, all my notes will be shifted to the nearest 16th note. So we set our pattern length to 2 bars, for example. Actually, before doing this, we need to have a look at our settings. So the quantize option should be set to none if you want to quantize after recording. And there's the record option, which quantizes the notes automatically after you've recorded them. And the play rec option actually quantizes the notes as you play them. So it's really limiting. I don't really use that. I never use that. I have always set it to none. So basically, quantization is also called timing correct, as it was actually called initially on the MPC that Roger Lin invented. Timing correct basically means that it corrects the timing of the notes that you play. So I would recommend that you leave it to none and you quantize after you've recorded your notes. Okay, so let's record some drums. Yeah, though these were pretty close actually to being spot on, but as we zoom in, you can actually see that the notes don't fall exactly on the grid. So by pressing quantize, we can actually make them conform to the grid. I'll press undo now to show you the quantize 50% option. So if you quantize it just 50%, it will set it halfway between where the note has landed when you played it and the actual grid. So if you press the quantize 50% option, it basically corrects the note slightly. And you can press the quantize 50% option a couple of times if you want to move the note closer to the grid. So the quantize 50% option actually lets us preserve our groove, but basically just tighten up our drums. So like I said, this basically conforms to the grid. Like if you set your grid to, for example, 8th notes, when you quantize your notes, they will actually go to the nearest 8th note. Now that I've set my grid to 8th notes, if I press quantize now, it actually moves to the nearest 8th note and not to the nearest 16th note. So now let's see how the step sequencer works, as it's also dependent on the grid that we've set. So the grid determines the resolution of the step sequencer. So if we have set it to 16th notes, as it is at the moment, let me set it to 16th actually. So if we have it set to 16th notes, each pad represents a 16th note of one bar of music. If I want to sequence my kick, let me just go to pad mode, make sure I have my kick selected. Then I go back to step mode and let me put my kick here, and you can see where the kick is landing in terms of its position in the bar. If I want to select another sound, I can go to pad mode, but I can also hold the select button, basically select my clap, and now I'm sequencing the clap. So I'll put the clap on the second and the fourth beat of the bar. And now I have a basic rhythm. Maybe I'll go to my kick and move this one here. So by pressing the pad, you can actually remove the note. So let's hear how it sounds. So yeah, let's go to the hi-hat and sequence the hi-hat. Okay, so I go to group B and then I have a bass sound. Let me record my bass sound. I've set the scale to E minor. Let's quantize it. I'll use the full quantize, not the 50%, because I want to apply swing later on, and swing works much better in my opinion if you have quantized it 100%. In my music, I actually prefer to play the parts without quantizing, but quantizing has its merits. It can sound really great at times, so I quantize it. Like I said, in terms of quantizing, you just need to make sure that your grid is set to the note value that you wish to quantize to. So let's now see how the swing option works. So the swing option is activated by pressing the swing button, and what you control here is basically the master swing. So what the master swing does is basically it delays some notes, makes them play a little bit later, and this creates a kind of groove, a kind of bouncing sound that's really much more effective in terms of making your head nod. This is the master swing, and as we turn the main encoder, you can see the master swing increase. I'll play the beat now and you'll hear how it sounds more and more swingy as I increase the swing value. So yeah, this is the master swing. Swing is determined if you go to your channel settings, and on the master you go to groove, and there's your swing amount, which you actually set with the main encoder, but you can also set it here. And there's this cycle thing, which is actually a bit confusing in my opinion. At this point we want to apply 16th note swing, right? But it says cycle 1/8, but cycle 1/8 is actually 16th note swing. And if you want to apply eighth note swing, you need to change your cycle to 1/4. And now you'll hear how eighth note swing sounds. One thing that's worth mentioning is that swing works like an effect. So the actual position of your MIDI notes in the sequencer doesn't change, but what you hear actually changes quite a lot. So let me go back to the channel thing and decrease the swing amount to 30, and I'll go back to 1/8. So like I said, this is the master swing, and it applies to all the groups that you have inside Maschine. One more thing that's worth mentioning is that the swing applies only if the actual note value that you set it your swing to is actually present in your beat. So for example, if you have a look at our drums, and if you're using the 16th note swing, it actually moves every second 16th note later. So for example, if we zoom in a little bit, so this first note doesn't move. The second one though is delayed. The third note is not really affected by the swing, and this one is actually affected. So basically, to sum it up, if you don't have 16th notes in your groove, in your rhythm, and you're using the 16th note swing, it actually won't do anything at all. So this is really, really important to mention. So let's go back to the channel settings. As we go to the group, we see that we have actually group swing. So we can actually apply swing to one group where it doesn't actually affect the other groups. There's also the sound swing. So we have swing at three different levels, at the sound level, at the group level, and at the master level. So you can apply swing to your, basically to just a single sound. You can actually swing just the hi-hat. As you saw, it's in the channel menu, but there's a really neat shortcut for actually swinging your sound. So you basically just hold this sound, you have the swing option activated here on the main encoder, and you just turn the main encoder and it actually swings just the sound that you're holding down. If you're swinging some sounds and not swinging other sounds, your groove may sound off. So swinging all your sounds with the same settings can actually make for a really tight groove. And of course, you can also do this at the group level. You just hold the group button and you just increase the swing. And now it's just the drums which are swinging and the bass line is not affected at all. But yeah, like I said, I would prefer to set them all to the same swing value. So what I do is just set my master swing to 32%. Let me just record some chords with the chords option. So let's quantize those, and there the swing is automatically applied to those because we set our master swing to 33%. So it applies to each and every sound and each and every group that we have inside of our machine project. We can actually try the arpeggiator now. We go to the note repeat section and there's our arpeggiator. The swing also applies to the arpeggiator. As you can hear, a neat trick is that you can actually automate the rate to record a pattern that's much more varied. So let's try this. Guys, I really appreciate you watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, turn on the notifications, because I'm gonna be uploading a lot more machine tutorials, Ableton Live tutorials, Ableton Live packs, and all that kind of good stuff. So yeah, make sure you're subscribed, and yeah guys, see you in the next video. Peace y'all.